Hi everybody, namaste, welcome to Green Living Path. Today I've got this amazing experience that happened to me many moons back. What happened was I was taking my parents to dinner at an Indian restaurant, and it finished reasonably late and I had to get back out to where I live on the west coast of New Zealand. And I was going through the Waitakeries, and it was a beautiful clear night, no stars around, just really clear. It was an interesting night actually, and it was about midnight and I was driving through the Waitakere Ranges, which is thick bush, and it's got this windy road like a snake that travels through the Waitakere Ranges. And it goes on for like quite a few kilometres of thick bush. And where I live is quite an isolated place out on the west coast by the ocean. Beautiful surf, waterfalls, black magnetic sand, huge rocks, and really amazing place to live. And so it was late in the evening and I was moving through the Waitakere Ranges in my car. The next thing that happened to me, I was pretty much in the middle of the Waitakere Ranges by myself, no cars around. It's quite a night, you know, it's midnight, and where I live it's isolated. There was this powder blue light coming through the car onto me, all over me. It was quite amazing really, and my logical mind was saying, oh, it's a electrical storm, it must be stormy outside, the clouds, the electrical storm. So I was, you know, that's the logical mind. And then my other self, my higher self, was saying it's way more than that. So I was getting the two, you know, different interpretations. I got to a stage where the blue light was so powdery blue, was so strong, I stopped the car, pulled over on the road, and there was this, the blue light was everywhere on the road, in the bush, all through the car, and my logical mind was saying, oh, it's an electrical storm still going through that. I looked up into the sky and the sky was absolutely clear except for this long shaped cigar cloud, which I felt was very unusual. It was as if it was the thing that emanated the blue light, and it was also like a way of cloaking the UFO that was inside the cloud. And there was no other clouds around for kilometers and kilometers. It was crystal clear night, beautiful night, and that was cigar shapes, and the blue light was everywhere. I'd been doing research for months on different beings, and I just bowed my head, my higher self, and says, thank you. Thank you, Anunnaki, which is a different race that lives in our planetary system or in the universe. So that's what I felt that it was. You can look that up, you can explore that. And I jumped in my car and was profoundly gratitude, thankful for what had happened to me. It's interesting because I wasn't in the fear. I was in more the love and gratitude space, 100%. So that's what I was emanating. I felt that was really important to emanate that side of things from the experience. And it was quite interesting to see how my logical mind was saying one thing, and my higher self, my essence, was was totally overriding it and saying, you know, that's not true at all. So that was quite an amazing experience. It had a profound effect on me. And as it happened, the experience helped open up my perception, because I believe a lot of people that go through life have a very narrow perception of things, what's right, what's wrong. And really, life is more about just lessons that are being taught to us constantly. The right or wrong side of things, in actual fact, is just lessons. That's the way I look at it, that are helping us evolve if we take those lessons on board and see past the judgment, right or wrong, looking at negative or positive, looking at the actual lessons that we're learning from that situation. And that situation of seeing the blue light, having that experience in the Waitakere Ranges, had a profound effect on opening up my bandwidth of perception, saying there's a lot more to the universe than we've been taught, and we're constantly being taught a very narrow, limited way of thinking, and predominantly we're being kept in a more fight or flight reactive state, more fear-based. And what we've got to realize is that we've got to come 100% from more love-based. And it's interesting, because I've just done a meditation for a couple of hours, and I've just written down on a piece of paper, it says, everything you do come from a place of love. So if you look at that, everything you do come from a place of love. So I've written that down. That's what came from my meditations. And I thought about that, and I realized that in our day-to-day life, a lot of what we do in our is habitual, and we're just going through the day-to-day things. But if you've got that understanding within inside yourself, everything you do, every action, everything, every person you interact with, everybody you meet, you just come from a place of love, then what happens is it transforms you energetically and lifts you, your vibration, upwards. And because you're 100% in that vibration of love, you're no longer being swayed and put into the fight or flight fear-based. You have a totally different perception of your world. And there's a kona, which is like a Zen Buddhism, which has sayings. And when I was little, very little, I read this saying, and it said, chopping wood. After enlightenment, chopping wood. And to me, the meaning has changed over decades and decades of practicing and doing yoga and meditation, is that I realize now, when you're in a state of love, the chopping wood beforehand and the chopping wood after, if you're in a state of love, is totally different. So that's where I'm coming from. So hopefully this helped you on your path. It's so awesome to have everybody here on Green Living Path, and it's beautiful to have people like yourself that want to actually take the time to move on up. And I believe in my heart that the highest form, the highest way you can live your life is growing your consciousness every single day, guys. So that's what I feel our main purpose is in this lifetime, is to grow our consciousness. Because when you grow your consciousness, you expand your consciousness, you actually have an effect in the quantum field on all things, on all beings, in a beautiful, loving, harmonious way. And you're more in the flow state. You're in the flow state. You've left the old ways behind. And I believe that's why all this happenings in the world that have happened over the past few years, keeping people isolated, force people to face themselves a lot more and to get out of the wheel of just doing things on the rat wheel, on the hamster wheel. So I feel that there is a transition now on the karmatic wheel, and we're going on the upswing, coming up. So that is where we're at. So it's really important to have people like you that are consciously trying to evolve and move on up and transform your life and be like a flower in full bloom, blooming. So thanks very much, guys. It's lovely to have you. This is Alyogi. Namaste. Have a lovely day. Bye.